Yes, good morning everyone. How are you all? Fine, I think so. We are all fine. So, welcome back to online classes again. So, in the last classes, we have done some of the revisions. Today, I am going to deal with the polynomials. It comes under algebra. Already, you know that in algebra, we have 20 marks. So, under algebra, we have the first chapter is polynomials, linear equations, quadratic equations, and arithmetic progressions. So these four will come under algebra only. So this is the first chapter that I am going to deal. So what is polynomial? See, in the lower classes or 8th class, we have learned some of the expression. This expression only we call as polynomial until and unless the power must be positive integral. That's all. Okay, na? What is that? If the power is positive integral, then it is a yes polynomial. Okay. So now, one more question that I ask you: is 1/x + 5 is a polynomial? The question. 1/x + 5 is a polynomial. What is the answer? No. Because if you write like this, what happened? x^-1 + 5. -1 is not a positive number. It is a negative number. Therefore, it is not a polynomial. One more example. √x + 7. Is it a polynomial? What is the answer? It is also no, because x^√ is nothing but 1/2 + 7. It should be positive integral, means it should be a positive integer. It should not be in the form of fraction, or it will not be in the form of rational number. Okay, na? Therefore, it should be purely positive integral. Then only we can say it is a polynomial. Okay. Now, there are many kinds of polynomials are there, like x + 5, x^2 + 2x - 7, x^3 + 2x² - 3x + 8, x^4 - 3x² + 7x. So here degree is 1, degree is 2, degree is 3, degree is 4. Depends upon the degree, the name will be there. So here degree is 1, therefore it is a linear polynomial. Linear means 1. Next one is quadratic polynomial. What is this? Quadratic polynomial. Here 3 is there, cubic polynomial. And here 4 is there, biquadratic. Biquadratic polynomial. But whatever may be the polynomial, we may do, but for us only quadratic polynomial only is there. In the last exercise, we will see some 4 or cubic polynomials like this. But we are mainly concentrating on quadratic polynomials. Okay? Na? Yes. How the polynomials will be? What we are going to learn from these polynomials? See, for example, x^2 + 2x + 1. It is a polynomial. We should find out its zeros. Do you know what is the meaning of zeros? Yeah, very simple. Zero. It is not equal zero. Okay? It is not equal equal zero. Zero means if you substitute. If you substitute the value in the given polynomial, in the given polynomial, then it should, or its value should become zero. Then only that number is known as zero of the given polynomial. Did you understand? Okay, example I'll show. Very simple example. For example, you take linear x plus 5. This is a linear polynomial. Just differentiate it to 0. Then x is equal to minus 5. This is nothing but 0 of this polynomial, because when you place x equal to minus 5, plus 5 gives answer as 0. If the value must be 0, then only that particular number is known as 0 of the given polynomial. Did you understand?
Yes.
Like that only we will find out in this quadratic polynomial. So how to find out? Like this we have seen in quadratic equations. That is splitting the middle term. We have seen like this. So I will write like this. X square plus x plus x plus 1. Actually the method is like this. If ax square plus bx plus c is a quadratic polynomial, then product, first we should find out its product. Product as a into c. Next sum. Sum means it is nothing but b. Therefore product is nothing but what? A into c. And sum is b. Now in this you see, what is the product? You just compare ax square plus bx plus c. A equal to 1 and c equal to 1 and b equal to 2. Now take a into c. A into c is equals to 1 into 1 is equals to 1. So 1 can be written as 1 into 1. Therefore 1 plus 1. These are the two factors of 2, of 1. Therefore x square plus x plus x plus 1. In these two, what is common? X. X plus 1. Again plus 1 you take common. X plus 1. Therefore x plus 1 into x plus 1. Therefore the zeros are x equal to minus 1 and minus 1. So what are the fact? What are the zeros? Minus 1 as well as minus 1. Did you understand? Like that only some questions we will solve, then you will understand. Some more questions like x square minus 3x plus 2. If you observe here also same, x square minus 2x minus x plus 2. You can verify your answer. Minus into minus is plus. 2 into 1 is 2. Minus 2x minus x is nothing but minus 3x. Therefore take x as common, x minus 2. Minus 1 means again x minus 2. Therefore x minus 2 into x minus 1. Therefore x equal to 2 and 1 are the zeros of the given polynomial. Did you understand? So like this we have to find out. Okay. But next concept is coefficients. So very important, it is nothing but coefficients. How the coefficients will be there? Coefficients. See, for example, the general form of quadratic polynomial is a square plus bx plus c. Here, if alpha and beta are the zeros, then alpha plus beta, that is their sum. Here very simple, first one will come plus, second one will come minus, again third one will come plus. If it is fourth one, it will become minus. That means what? Alternate signs. One plus, one minus. Okay. Now alpha plus beta equal to minus b by a. That means what? Minus the coefficient of x divided by the coefficient of x square. Next one, that is product alpha into beta c by a. That means nothing but constant divided by the coefficient of x square. Okay, now you should find like this. So what is alpha plus beta? Minus b by a. What is alpha into beta? C by a. This you remember
then we have to compare the coefficients with like that. Okay, na? We compare. Now we'll take one problem and we'll show our C is correct only, right?
Right.
One small problem and take 6x square minus 7x minus 3. 6x square minus 7x minus 3. So very very simple. First we should multiply 3 into 6, that is 18. The factors of 18, 18 into 1, 9 into 2, next 6 into 3, like that. Yes, so 6 3 is 18, 18 plus 1, 19, not there. So therefore this will not work. 9 plus 2, 11, not there. 9 minus 2, 7 is there. Therefore it is correct. Therefore you should write like this. 6x square minus 9x plus 2x minus 3. You can verify it. Minus into plus, minus. Minus 9x plus 2x. It is nothing but minus 7x. Now, in this and in this, what is common? 3x is common. Therefore, again, 2x minus 3 plus 1, 2x minus 3. See, very very important step is, whatever getting in the same, this bracket, same should be get in the same bracket. Okay, in this bracket. If these two are different, then your answer will come wrong. Okay, na? Therefore, again, what is common? 2x minus 3 is common. Therefore, what is the answer? 3x plus 1. Therefore, roots are x equal to 3 by 2 and x equal to minus 1 by 3. Okay, na? Now, we will compare the coefficients. So, what I told coefficients? 6x square minus 7x. Minus 3, so alpha plus beta, if alpha and beta are the zeros of this polynomial, then alpha plus beta equal to minus b by k, therefore minus into minus plus 7 by 6. So you take these two, now 3 plus 2 minus 1 by 3, it is equal to 6 is the LCM, 2 3 ka, 3 3 ka 9, minus 1, therefore 2 3 ja 6, 3 3 ja 9, 3 2 ja, it is nothing but 7 by 6. See the answer. Okay, na? Same thing you will get it. Next one, alpha into beta equal to minus 3 by 6 or minus half. Now take this. Now take this, these two, that is 3 by 2 into minus 1 by 3. So 3 3 cancel, it is nothing but minus 2. You see that? So like this we have to compare the coefficients. Are you understanding? Therefore alpha and beta are the zeros and we compare the coefficients like this. Did you understand? Yes. Some more problem will you guys will understand more. Yes? Yeah. One more example we'll take and we'll prove or we'll find out its coefficient. We'll verify. Okay, na? Right. One more problem. 3x square minus x plus minus 4. Now, first I told 3 into 4, that is 12. 12 can rise, 12 into 1, 6 into 2, 4 into 3. Now, whichever possible you can take them. 12 plus 1, 13, 12 minus 1, it is not there. 6 plus 2, 8, 6 minus 2, 4, it is not there. 4 plus 3, 7, 4 minus 3 is 1. Therefore, you can take it. Therefore, 3x square minus 4x plus 3x minus 4. Now, you can write it like this. 3x square plus 3x minus 4x and minus 4. 3x, if you take common, x plus 1. Minus 4 you take common, x plus 1. If you have any confusion or doubt, you can verify your answer in here itself. Minus into plus is minus. 4 into x is 4x. Minus into plus is minus. 4 into 1 is 4 also. Okay, now? Therefore, what is the answer? Again, x plus 1 and remaining will be 3x minus 4. Therefore, x equal to minus 1 and x equal to 4 by 3. Now we compare the coefficients. Yes. First one is, write this, 3x square minus x minus 4 alpha plus beta. So minus of minus 1 divided by 3, it is 1 by 3. You can write it minus 1 plus 4 by 3. So it is nothing but equal to cross multiplication minus 3 plus 4 divided by 3 equal to 1 by 3. Same, both are same. Next, multiplication alpha into beta, that is minus 4 by 3. Here you can do minus 1 into 4 by 3 equal to minus 4 by 3. This is also correct. This is also correct. So if they last this form, verify the coefficients, then it is nothing but 3 marks question. Otherwise, it is only for 2 marks question. Did you understand?
Yes.
Next. Yes. Then we start our questions. Find the zeros of the polynomials x square minus 2x minus 8. Yes. So here we have to find out only zeros. There is no verification. Okay, na? Now x square minus 2x minus 8. Product is 8. 8 into 1. 4 into 2, that's all. Therefore, 8 plus 1, 9, 8 minus 1, 7, not there. 4 plus 2, 6, 4 minus 2, 2 is there. That means what we can take, we should take only these two factors. X square minus 4x plus 2x minus 8. However you want, you can take this no method. You can take like this also, plus 2x minus 4x minus 8. This is also same. Now x if you take common, x plus 2, minus 4 you take, again x plus 2. So x plus 2 is 1 0, and x minus 4 is one more factor. Therefore x equal to minus 2 and 4. Okay, na? Yes. Next problem. 4x square minus 4x and minus 1, sorry, plus 1. Again 1 into 4. So here we have only factors are like this, 4 into 1 and 2 into 2. This will not work out, but this 2 into 2 plus 2, 4 will work out. Okay, na? How to do this? 4x square minus 2x minus 2x plus 1. Now in this 2 you take 2x as common, then it is nothing but 2x minus 1. Minus 1 if you take 2x minus 1. See, many students will confuse here. No confusion. Plus minus into plus is minus. 1 into 2x is 2x. Minus into minus is plus. 1 into 1 is 1 only. Understood? Therefore, 2x minus 1 into 2x minus 1. Therefore, x equal to half and half. Okay, na? Like this you should solve the or find out the zeros of the given polynomials. Understood?
Yeah.
I think so. Remaining you do it. Remaining, yes. We'll take another set of problems so that we have a practice. Yeah, and he is also asking for verification. No problem, sorry, I forgotten. Now you can take the verification. 4x square minus 4x plus 1. Here x equal to half and x equal to half equal. Now alpha plus beta, that is 4 by 4 is equals to 1. So half plus half is equals to 1. Verification. Very simple. Now alpha into beta equal to 1 by 4, therefore 1 you can write, 2 zeros we have, 1 by 2 into 1 by 2 equal to 1 by 4. This is also correct and this is also correct. Okay na? Yes. So you can do the verification. One more problem he has given, very simple problem. T square minus 15. Here many students will confuse. No need of confusion actually it is. Here actually it is two terms means it is in the form of a square minus b square. We should try it like this. Very simple. T square minus root 15 whole square. T square minus root 15 square. Therefore, t plus root 15 and t minus root 15. That's all. These are the answers. Okay, na? If you want, you can clarify that out. T equal to, yes, one is root 15 minus root 15 and plus root 15. Okay, na? Now, this you can write like this. T square plus 0 into T minus 15. Therefore, alpha plus beta equal to 0 into 1 is equals to 0. Because you can clarify, plus root 15 minus root 15 both cancel, answer will become 0. Okay na? Now multiplication you see, yes, minus 15 by 1 is equals to minus 15. Now you can clarify, plus root 15 into minus root 15. Minus root 15 into root 15 is 15 only. Therefore, like this we have to verify. Okay, na? Understood? So this has 0 and this is minus 450. Yes. One more problem we will take. We will verify. Then we will understand better than this. Now you can see 3x square minus x minus 4. First, what we have to do? First, we should multiply. 3 into 4 is 12. The factors of 12 into 1, 6 into 2, and 4 into 3. You can write these 3. Okay, na? Now, here, minus 1 is there. So, 12 plus 1, 13. 12 minus 1, 11. Not there. 6 plus 2, 8. 6 minus 2, 8. 4 is not there. 4 minus 3, 1 is there. Yes, therefore here minus is greater, therefore we will take minus as 4. So 3x square minus 4x plus 3x minus 4. It is nothing but splitting the middle term. When we have 4 terms, then only we can take common. If 3 terms are there, we can't take common. Okay? So to avoid this, we are making this as 4. Physically we are disturbing, but mentally we are not at all disturbing. Okay? Now see. You can write like this, 3x square plus 3x minus 4x minus 4. So 3x if you take common x plus 1, minus 4 if you take x plus 1. Therefore x plus 1 and 3x minus 4, x equal to minus 1 and x equal to 4 by 3. Okay na? Now we will verify with alpha plus beta. Alpha plus beta equal to 1 divided by 3. Okay, na? Now you can take it.
Yes.
Minus of minus 3 is okay. Now minus 1 plus 4 by 3. Here 1, therefore what happened? Minus 3 plus 4 by 3, therefore 1 by 3. Verified. Next, alpha into beta equal to minus 4 by 3. So here minus 1 into 4 by 3, therefore minus 4 by 3. Okay, now please take that. So in this type of questions, how many problems if you solve, then that much you will be perfect. Okay, na? So don't practice 1, 2, 3 problems, then don't feel like that. So how many problems? Whichever book you want, you can take it. Right?
Yes.
Some more? Yes. He has given. Find the quadratic polynomial.
Yes.
Polynomial he has given. As some might.
Yes.
How to find out the quadratic polynomial? There are two methods are there. One is, if alpha and beta given, find sum and product given. Very very simple. Okay, na? If alpha and beta given means directly we can get it. But when sum and product given, how to find out? Actually, it is like this. We know x plus a into x plus b equal to x square plus x into a plus b plus ab. So this is the identity we know, but here I told you when you are verifying, if you take alpha beta, then this sign should change, because I told first one will be as it is, second one will be minus, third one will be plus sign. Therefore this is the required polynomial. Okay, na? So on this basis we will do the problems. Now, sum is 1 by 4 and product is minus 1. Sum is 1 by 4 and product is 1. Very, very simple. Right? X square minus x into sum is 1 by 4 plus it is minus 1. If it is like this, just you multiply with 4 only. 4x square minus x minus 4. That's all. This is the answer. Okay, na? This is the required polynomial. One more. Root 2 and 1 by 3. Root 2 and 1 by 3. No problem. X square minus x into a plus b. That is alpha plus beta and alpha beta. Now very simple, x square minus x into root 2 plus 1 by 3. Now multiply 4 by 3, what do you get? 3 into x square, 3x square minus 3 root 2x plus 1. This is the required polynomial. Okay, na? Like this we have to write. Next problem. First, let me finish the NCERT exercise, then we go for more problems from other reference books. Okay, na? Yes. Yes. 0 and root 5. 0, root 5. 0 is sum and this is product. Okay, na? Now very very simple. Now take, yes, required polynomial will be x square minus x into alpha plus beta plus alpha beta. Therefore x square minus x into 0 plus root 5. Therefore what is the answer? X square plus root 5. Over. Like this only you should write. Okay, na? Next question. 1 minus 1 by 4 and 1 by 4. Product is 1 by 4 and sum is minus 1 by 4. Therefore, required polynomial is x square minus x into alpha plus beta plus alpha beta. Now, x square minus x into alpha plus beta is minus 1 by 4, alpha beta is 1 by 4. Therefore, x square minus into minus plus x by 4 plus 1 by 4. We are not supposed to keep like this, therefore, multiply root by 4, we will get 4x square plus x plus 1, like this. Okay? Yes. One more question. 4 and 1. 4 and 1. Sum is 4 and product is 1. Now you can get it. Required polynomial x square minus x into alpha plus beta plus alpha beta. Then what happens? X square minus x into 4 plus 1. Therefore, x square minus 4x plus 1. Reverse also you can get it again. Alpha plus beta minus b by a. Therefore, minus of minus 4 divided by 1 is 4. Alpha into beta c by 1. Therefore, 1 by 1 equal to 1 like this. Okay, na? So we should know this also, we should know that also, so that we can verify it by ourselves. Okay. Yes, some more problems we will solve. X square minus 3x minus 10. Yes. Now, minus 10. 10 can have 10 into 1, 5 into 2. Only these 4 factors are there. 10 plus 1 is 11. 10 minus 1 is 9. It is not there. 5 plus 2 is 7. 5 minus 2 is 3. Therefore, we can write it. X square minus 5x plus 2x minus 10. Now, take x as common. X minus 5 plus 2, x minus 5. Therefore, x minus 5 into x plus 2. Therefore, x equal to 5 and x equal to minus 2 are the answers. Now you can verify with the coefficients. How to verify with the coefficients? Yes. X square minus 3x minus 10. Now see, alpha plus beta minus of minus 3 by 1, it is nothing but 3. Now you can take 5 minus 2 equal to 3, both one and the same. Correct or not? Yes. Next, alpha into beta, that is minus 10 by 1 is equals to minus 10. Now 5 into minus 2 equal to minus 10, like this. Okay, na? Yes. So, this is nothing but verification. Okay, na? Another problem. Take one by one. How many problems will practice? That much you will be perfect in this problem wise. Okay, na? Yes. 2x square minus 6x minus 20. Now see, 20 into 2, that is 40. 40 should be diverted as minus 6. So take, how will you come? 2 into 20 is 40. 40 means we have 40 into 1, 20 into 2, 10 into 4, 8 into 5. This will not come, this will not come. See, 10 plus 4, 14, 10 minus 4, 16. There are directly will come. 2x square minus 10x plus 4x minus 20. Now, 2x is common, x minus 5 plus 4, if you take x minus 5. Therefore, x minus 5 is one factor and 2x plus 4 is another factor. Right? Now, that means what? X equal to 5 and x equal to minus 2. Otherwise, minus 4 by 2 is nothing but minus 2. Now you can verify 2x square minus 6x minus 20 alpha plus beta, that is 6 by 2 is equals to 3. Now you can directly 5 minus 2 equal to 3. Okay na? Next, alpha into beta minus 20 by 2 is equals to minus 10. Therefore, 5 into minus 2 equal to minus 10. Okay? So, you should calculate like this. Yes, one more. X square by 2 minus 3 by 2x minus 5. If you want, you can do directly like this, but denominator is there. I will make it without denominator. That is multiply 4 by 2. What happens? X square minus 3x minus 10 will come. That's all. Very simple. Before only we have done this problem, right? Now you can take directly x square minus 5x plus 2x minus 10. Okay, now x if you take common, x minus 5 plus 2 if you take x minus 5. Therefore, x minus 5 plus, into x plus 2, therefore x equal to 5 and minus 2. Yes, x equal to 5 and minus 2 are the zeros of the polynomial. Take now x square minus 3x minus 10. So if you take sum of the roots, it is minus of minus 3 divided by 1 is nothing but plus 3. Therefore, 5 minus 2 equal to 3. Right? Now again, product of the roots, it is nothing but c by a, that is minus 10 by 1 minus 10. Now 5 into minus 2 equal to minus 10. Okay? Na? So you can verify your doubts like this only. Right? If you are getting same answer, then it is correct. Otherwise, you have done something wrong. Okay? So for that purpose only, verification if you ask, you can do. If they will not ask you, so if time is there, you can verify your doubt by yourself. If you have doubt, if you don't have doubt, you are confident, then there is no problem. Okay na? Yes, 3x square, one more problem. 3x square minus 9x minus 13. So very very simple problem. Okay na? 3 into 30, that is 90. We have 90 into 1, 45 into 2, next 30 into 3, next 4 will come, no, 4 to जा नो फाइव फाइव मीन्स 18 इंटू फाइव देन सिक्स सिक्स मीन्स 15 इंटू सिक्स वेरी आर This will not come, but this will come. 15 minus 6 is nothing but 9 only, correct or not? Now directly you can take 3x square minus 15x plus 6x minus 13. Now, 3x if you take common, what happened? X minus 5 plus 6 if you take again x minus 5. So x minus 5 and 3x plus 6. Therefore x equal to 5 and x equal to minus 2. Okay na? Now we verify ourselves. 3x square minus 9x minus 30. Okay na? Just you take and do like this. Now alpha plus beta. So minus of minus 9 divided by 3, it is nothing but 3 only. Therefore, you can take it 5 minus 2 equal to 3. Okay. Now second, alpha into beta equal to minus 30 by 3 is equals to minus 10. Therefore, 5 into minus 2 equal to minus 10 like this. Okay? I hope you understood this session. So in the next class, we will do the log division method as well as how to find out the remaining roots if it is a biquadratic polynomial or cubic polynomial or polynomial which has degree as 5 or 6 or like this. Depends upon the okay, I hope you understood this session. Enjoy the session. Yes, okay. Thank you. God bless you.